Transbronchial biopsy. The question is, how would you code a transbronchial biopsy of the left lower lobe of the lung with BAL washings, but with no lung tissue identified on the path report? So let me bring that up. So the first thing is, what's a BAL? It's a bronchoscopic alveolar lavage. So they're basically sending some fluid in there, trying to get some cells that they kind of aspirate out or they suck off to go diagnose if there's any problems. So this is a diagnostic procedure. And if you want to learn more, go to the Olympus-Me website. On there they said that BAL aims to establish a diagnosis and to find out if there's infections or malignancy. So it's amazing what they can do just by getting the cell washing. And present and to estimate the degree of the disease activity. Fluid is introduced into the terminal bronchioles. That's what you're seeing here. So this tube comes down, it goes down pretty far, and then recollected for analysis to examine cells, inhaled particles, infectious organisms, or fluid constituents. Okay? Now, what is the code? The code is 31624, bronchoscopy, rigid or flexible, including fluoroscopic guidance when performed with the BAL. Okay, so that's the code that basically described what the questioner was asking. But let's take a look at what it looks like in Find a Code. Okay, so this Find a Code is one of our preferred encoders that we use. Is that big enough? There we go. So what I love about this is the plain English description. So it's really giving us, in layman's terms, what's going on. So it says a rigid or flexible bronchoscope is inserted through the nose or mouth and advanced to the oropharynx with or without fluoroscopic guidance. And fluoroscopic guidance, by the way, is if you think of the Three Stooges and those episodes where they would run behind the x-ray screen and you could see their skeleton moving, that's fluoroscopy. It's a moving x-ray instead of like the you know, static picture type. And they use that to help them locate where they're putting the bronchoscope so, you know, it doesn't damage going down. The oropharynx is examined, the vocal cords are visualized, the bronchoscope is then advanced in the trachea, which is also examined before the scope is advanced into each main stem bronchus, because we have a right and left bronchus, and any abnormalities are noted. If a rigid bronchoscope is used, a telescope or flexible bronchoscope may be inserted through the rigid bronchoscope to visualize the distal segment. So it's, think of like a like this hard tube, but they can put the flexible one inside of the hard tube to go down into the real deeper recesses there. Then it says bronchioalveolar secretions from the lower respiratory tract are obtained by BAL. The bronchoscope is wedged into the subsegmental bronchus containing the lung lesion. If diffused lung disease is present, the scope is wedged into the right middle lobe bronchus. Sterile normal saline is instilled through the scope and aspirated back into the specimen trap using suction. So here's a great picture, another feature of Find a Code that we like. Oops, there we go. And here it's showing it from a different perspective than the one I showed earlier. So you can see the bronchoscope, it's inserted through the mouth or the nose. They examine the pathway all the way down, and then they do these washings at the end. Okay, so that's what that procedure is and how it works. Okay, so to code this particular situation, it doesn't matter that nothing was found, because she was asking, they didn't find anything wrong. It was a diagnostic procedure, so they, you know, it was negative, which is good for the patient. So the fact that they didn't find any pathology, you would still code it CPT code 31624. Now, from a diagnostic standpoint, I didn't really have enough information as to what the physician, you know, why they ordered the procedure, so I am assuming that the questioner was asking about the CPT procedure. So that's a BAL.
Do you need more medical certification training? Go to www.cco.us. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for updates.